Let's look at an application of integrals and their properties to statistics. In statistics, we have something called the standard normal distribution. Standard normal distribution. There are also just plain old normal distributions. The standard normal distribution, very special curve. You might say it's the most useful curve in the universe. Last time we talked about the most beautiful equation in the universe, e to the I pi plus 1 equals 0. Here, yes, if you get abducted by aliens again, and this time they ask you what's the most useful curve in the universe, you can say, I know it's the normal curve. You might even say the standard normal curve. Bell-shaped curve, centered at 0. The inflection points on either side here turn out to be at 1 and negative 1. Remember inflection points? You can see the second derivative changes sign. The concavity changes here. It's concave up over here, concave down in the middle, concave up over here. We might be wondering, in a statistics class, what is the area under this curve between negative 2 and positive 2? What is this area that I'm shading? Area equals question mark. I need a formula for this standard normal curve. What is the formula? A little complicated. It's 1 over square root of 2 pi times e to the negative x squared over 2 power. That's the formula for the standard normal curve. That's not on the test. You do not need to know that formula. I want to know what that area is. If this is the formula for this curve, by what we've been talking about, the area has got to be the integral of the curve from negative 2 to 2. First application of a property. This function is even. If you replace x with negative x, you get this. Negative x quantity squared is the same as x squared. That negative sign doesn't go away. It stays there. This is the same as that. Order of operations is important in here. When you see this expression, negative x squared over 2, you should first figure out x squared over 2 and then put a negative sign in front of it. We are not squaring negative x here. We are doing x squared and then putting a negative sign in front of it. So since it's even, we can do 2 times the integral from 0 to 2. This integral here is something you can look up in a table. In fact, I'll even show you the table I share with my stats students. Here's an example of a table that I use for my stats class. It is a standard normal curve, and those areas that are to the left of numbers are labeled probabilities, but you don't need to worry about that. We're after an upper limit of integration of 2. So this column that says z, I first want to look for a 2.0 right there. And then I want to use the first number in the next column here because the decimal expansion I really want is 2.00. This number, this 0.9772. Okay, well, the table's a little different than I was hoping, actually. That's not the area that is between 0 and 2. But that number minus 0.5 is. 0.9772 minus 0.5 is 0.4772. Why did I subtract 0.5? Because the table gave me the area under this curve to the left of 2 forever, including to the left of negative 2. I wanted just this area right here, for this integral at least, not for the entire answer. So I had to subtract the area to the left of zero, which by symmetry is 1/2. It turns out the total area under this curve is 1. I forgot to mention that. So the area to the left of zero is 0.5. So that 0.9772 minus 0.5 is what this integral is. I do need to multiply it by 2 to get the total green area. 2 times 0.4772. The total green area is about 0.9544. That's the final answer here for 2 times the integral, 0.9544. That's the total shaded green area. And if you've had stats before, you might remember the 68, 95, 99.7 rule. About 95% of the area is between negative 2 and 2. It's said to be within 2 standard deviations of the mean. If you haven't had statistics, don't worry about what that means. All right, it's about 0.9544. So I applied the fact that this function is even. What else could I do? So that's right. Here's a way you could confirm the answer on a calculator. You have to go to what's called a distribution menu right here, do the second function and click that button right there. And then normal CDF is what we want to use. You don't need to know this, but I'll just quickly type in negative 2 to 2. When I paste this, I should get 0.9544. Yes, 9545 if you round it correctly. I guess my doubling of the number was ignoring some rounding, and that's why we're off a tiny bit. 0.9544 versus 0.9545. That one's more accurate, actually. What else can we illustrate here, though, related to properties of integrals? We can illustrate the theorem about with the little m and the capital M. For example, for the area under the curve from 0 to 1, for example, this normal curve from 0 to 1 looks about like that. What can I use for little m and what can I use for capital M? Well, capital M is easy. Well, okay, capital M is going to be f of 0. Plug in 0 here, you're going to get e to the 0 is 1. It's going to be 1 over square root of 2 pi. What is that approximately? By the way, don't worry about where this square root of 2 pi comes from. 1 divided by square root of 2 pi is about 0.3989. That's a value that the function's always underneath. What's the value of little m? By the way, little m and capital M are best lower and upper bounds, as in chapter 1 as well. It would be f of 1. Plug in x equals 1. What do you get? That's going to be 1 over square root of 2 pi e to the negative 1 squared is 1, negative 1/2 power. Take this previous answer and multiply it by e to the negative 0.5 power. It's about 0.2420 if you round correctly. Let's use that as my little m. Because of this, the integral, again, is going to be between, now it's the integral from 0 to 1, it's going to be between these two values. A is 0, B is 1, B minus A is 1. Therefore, the integral is going to be between these two numbers. Therefore, 0.2420 is less than or equal to the integral, is less than or equal to 0.3989. That's not the original problem as before. Now I'm integrating from 0 to 1, not negative 2 to 2, not 0 to 2. It's a different problem, trying to illustrate one of those other properties. Okay, you might say this is close to being a straight line. It's not straight. So in reality, the integral is probably about halfway between these numbers. It's probably in the ballpark of 0.3, what? 3132, somewhere in there. Let's have the calculator do it. I'll use that normal distribution again. Normal CDF. Now I'll put a 0 and a 1 there. I should get an answer for that area between these two numbers. I'm guessing close to halfway between them. About 0.31 or 32 or so. I was off, 0.34. Okay, I'm far enough off because this is not straight. The area is a bit bigger than what I was guessing. What I was guessing with the 0.31 or 0.32 would be the area of a trapezoid. But because this graph's concave down, the graph is higher than the straight line between these points. So you get slightly more area, 0.34 is what the answer is. But it is between these two numbers. Let's end class by emphasizing that to find this kind of integral more precisely, we really do need sums, maybe a left-hand sum, right-hand sum, average them for trapezoid sums, or something more advanced, like what I mentioned called Simpson's rule. And that you really do need those things because this function one over square root of 2π times e to the negative x squared over 2 is not a function you are capable of finding an antiderivative of. In fact, it's not a function that I'm capable of finding antiderivative of. An antiderivative or antiderivative does exist, but it's just a function you never heard of before. That one. 1/2 erf of x over square root of 2. Erf, what's that? Mathematica, help. What is erf? Just type it in here. Erf. Erf. Erf z gives the error function. Well, what's that? Okay, so ERF stands for error function. What's the error function? It's a function you've never heard of before. Why is it called the error function? Because the normal curve does accurately model errors in experiments. It does accurately model errors in experiments. It's an honest-to-goodness function. You can plot it. Plot this function. There it is. You can find its values. I can say, Mathematica, what is this function 1/2 erf of x over square root of 2? Oops. Evaluated at, say, x equals 0.5. Oh, it's about 0.191462. What did Mathematica do to find that? Well, it was either programmed into the system with data, or it did an integral and it approximated the integral. It's an honest to goodness function that can be evaluated and graphed. It also has a derivative equal to the standard normal distribution right there. Capital D means derivative. It is a function that exists and it's continuous and differentiable, and you can graph it. It's just got a different name because it's not like any function you've seen before. There are plenty of functions you've never seen before. So that emphasizes the final important aspect of integrals is that they can be used to define new functions that are often useful. ERF being a primary example, the error function.